Crusader Kings 2. This is The Wolf's Revenge. Ooh. Okay, I'll stop. Anyways, last episode we had a war breakout between the Lion and the Stag. Tywin of the House Lannister has declared war against King Renly, the Broke King of the Copper Throne. And I've been talking to some people in the comment section. We don't really know why Tywin is doing this. This is kind of suicidal here, because we can see Tywin here has got 42, maybe 43,000 men. King Renly has 53,000 men. So right off the bat, he already outnumbers King Tywin by about 10. Is that really 10? No, it's not 10,000 men. Is it? He really has a 10,000 men advantage, if it'll let me fucking click on it. Yes. So Tywin's starting this off already at a disadvantage. Not only that, but he also doesn't have many allies. As of right now, he could get more allies later on, and maybe that's part of Tywin's plan, is he's going to get allies later on. But right now, King Renly has Lord Mace of the Reach on his side, who brings another 31,000 men, who's also our ally. Although, that's really not going to matter for us right now, mainly because we're not going to concern ourselves with this war. We're not going to fight for our liege. We're not going to fight for anybody. We're not going to concern ourselves with it for now. We're going to wait. It seems the consensus is we're going to wait, and we're going to let the enemies kill each other. We're going to have them waste each other's men in a devastating war, and then we're probably going to break free. We're probably going to become independent. And that's mainly because we can't really find anybody that we want to support for the Iron Throne. I think at this point, Eddard sees the Iron Throne being, well, pretty fucking corrupt. And so now we're going to get our own independence. Now, it is going to be 2 more years before Eddard Stark, he's going to be graying in the face. He's going to be graying here soon. But you know what? I think he's earned it. I think he's earned the right to be a gray old man, considering how frequently he seems to die. So I'm gonna get the timer going here. There's a good chance we might experience some... Slow that down a little bit. Out of curiosity... I was thinking maybe we could ally with the Greyjoys, but Theon Greyjoy is a bastard, even though he has multiple kids who are part Stark. Oh well, that's fine. He also seems to be being controlled by the Iron Throne. I'm not sure if he deliberately chose to do that. Very strange. But we will need to keep an eye on developments here. Okay, things are breaking up. What is? Okay, all right. So here's something. Lord Paramount Tywin of the Westerlands is the attacker. He has more allies now, and the Vale has joined him. The Vale. Harold Arryn, you fool. What are you doing? All right, so he has the Vale on his side, but that probably means King Renly has more men as well. He has Lord Paramount, Jaime of Lawnmont, Catelyn of Harrenhal. It seems our wife Catelyn is fighting in this war as well. That's not very good. That's not really good. I think Renly still vastly outnumbers Tywin, but Tywin does have an ally in the Vale. Interesting. It's not good that Catelyn is she known as the Fearless? Nice. It's not good for her that she's throwing her men away, but she's only throwing away some, not all of them. And the Vale is going to be expending itself as well. I wonder if we couldn't get Prince Doran to help us. Princess Elia of Dorne. Elia Martell. Oh, okay. Multiple people named Elia. Tristan Martell, Gavin Sand, Arya. Oh, yeah. Prince Oberyn is now a gray old man. All right, okay. So Dorne is sitting this one out. They have 18,000 men. But the West, the Reach, the Iron Throne, and the Vale are all going to war, along with the Stormlands and the Greyjoys. So it leaves just the North and most of the Riverlands, plus Dorne. If we could get Dorne to ally with us, then we can hit them from the North and the South when we go for independence. Can we declare war on him now? Claim. Okay, we would have to wait for the war to be over, but now might be a good time. I mean, when we go to war, Mace is gonna have to make a choice. He's gonna have to make a choice, because Margaery is actually in Moat Cailin, and he knows that if they go to war, if they aid Renly in our crusade for independence, Lady Margaery could very well become a hostage. Let us begin trying to sway Prince Doran. He might not be around much longer, though. He is 63. And then there's Lord Quentin, who has married Sorella Sand. All right. But we do need to keep an eye on the battles and stuff. So I think the best way to probably do that would be to move our spymaster. Let's see. Can he scheme? We could send him to scheme in Stony Sept. But we can already kind of see. I want to see where the Fog of War is. Yeah, no. We'll have to do build a spy network. My lord, whilst investigating the rumor of a plot in Winterfell, I was attacked by armed thugs. I barely escaped with my life, and I'm now severely wounded. And that is Lord Benjen Alcastle, and sinister forces are at work. Indeed. Go ahead and build a spy network in King's Landing, and we'll keep an eye on this guy. You know, if we wanted to get independence, we can't. I was gonna say if we plot to kill King Renly, but we're Eddard Stark. We don't do that. Maybe one day when we're playing as Tywin Lannister, we can do that. But we're not gonna do that as Lord Eddard. Instead, we're going to keep an eye on everything around us. We just kind of want to see how the battle is going to unfurl. I want to see how many men they lose before all of this is over. Apparently, he's got 36,000 men. What is going on? Holy cow! Meanwhile, We need to be building up our forces. Now, where are all of our... We have... Let's see. Kingdom of the Trident. Okay, I think Winterfell has got max troops. No, it hasn't, actually. Okay, we're going to keep building men. Let's see. 24k plus 6,000. That is roughly 30-some-odd thousand men. So we are topping out. Yeah, but the Riverlands should have a lot more. I mean, if I want to train troops... Can I only send them to places that I own? Yeah, I can only send them to places that I own. Okay, so continue training troops in Winterfell. But we are seeing there are a few places down here in the Riverlands where they still need to build up their forces, so we're not at full strength yet. People are telling me crazy shit like we should have 60k men and stuff. And Rob has the flu. We don't want him to die. His heir is going to be Eddard Stark, who is clubfooted. Of course he is. Reynard Stark would be better. He's got the Tyrell appearance. My lord, since I arrived in Winterfell, all right, he's got more reinforcements. Great, but we need to keep an eye on Renly's forces. What is going on? His men are getting chewed up. 30,000. How much does Tywin have? 30,000. Ooh, things have become shockingly even. See, 3% in favor of Lord Paramount Tywin the Merciless. My lord, I write on behalf of the Iron Bank. Rob, what are you doing? Apparently he owes him money. Loan taken, lack of funds. I will pay it on your behalf. I shall issue a reprimand. Placate the envoy with smooth words. We're building up the war chest. Excellent. Perhaps I should use my extensive military knowledge to impress Prince Doran into liking me more. My military exploits are sure to amaze him. Let's just talk strategy. Now, I don't think we're going to make a faction for independence, because I think it's going to take too long. But what we can do is, as soon as the war ends, we can just instantly declare war for independence, and then maybe by that time... I mean, if we're lucky and Mace Tyrell supports us, we got this in the bag. It's easy. Okay, they formed an alliance, but Mace Tyrell and Dorne on our side would give us all the men we need, assuming that Tywin doesn't lose. News from the Battle of the Hayford, my lord. Your ally, Lord Paramount Mace Tyrell, has been slain. He was killed in direct single combat by the enemy commander, Sir Davin Lannister. So does that mean our alliance is now crumbled? Is that what that means? No offer, non-aggression pact. You would dare. You would dare, sir. Who are you married to? Alice of the Reach. Okay. All right, so Mace is gone. Mace is gone, and we can't offer a non-aggression pact yet for political concerns. We could attack Oh, man. I saw this and I got really excited. I was like, wait a minute. It's like, you're telling me we could claim the Reach. But it would go to Marjorie Tyrell. It wouldn't go to any of our children. So, I mean, really? Hold on. Let's see. Rob. Rob's better. That's great. You're telling me that Eddard doesn't have any claims on the Reach. Let's see. She has a claim on the Kingdom of the Reach, but none of her children do. Well, that's kind of shit. Perhaps... Rob. If we were playing as Rob, we could invade the Reach, and we could take it over from Marjorie, his wife. And so they would have the combined power, I think. Right? Because that's kind of what happened here. Eddard rules in Winterfell, and Catelyn rules in Harrenhal. And she rules the Trident. Well, she rules in Harrenhal, but we actually have the Kingdom of the Trident. How could we get the Kingdom of the Reach? Because if we could get that too, we would be unstoppable. But the Veil would be more strategic to our purposes. They got a lot of children. Lord Darnold of the Veil, Lady Brienne, is 8. Is there anyone we can marry her to? Any Starks? No, we have no Starks that we can marry them to. Or at least not in our court, not in our court. Interesting developments. But we also can't seem to ally with Lord Wyllys. He's also not aiding Renly. Renly actually has lost his ally. Let's see. King Renly has Lord Jaime of Longmont, Queen Catelyn of the North, where she only commands the men of Harrenhal, I believe. But no Lord Paramounts, whereas Tywin has Lord Paramount Herald of the Vale. Maybe Tywin knew that Lord Mace was going to get killed. Possible. It is possible. But now it's kind of like, well, I want Lord Wyllys on our side. Alright, fuck it. Let's sway him. Sway him, get him on our side, and we'll see how the war evolves. 3% in favor of King Renly. He has 28,000 men. You can see people fighting over here. Some fighting. Doing some fighting. King Renly Baratheon. Of the Iron Throne has long held me in low esteem, mainly for supposed slights made against the honor of his house. Now the fool has kidnapped one of my kin for allegedly straying into his lands. You would dare. You would dare. Who did he kidnap? He kidnapped Rickon Stark. Ooh. The insolence. I demand their release. Let's see how many men you have, Renly. 27,000. We actually outnumber Renly now. Renly, you son of a bitch. Why does he hate us? I have forgotten. Fought in a duel, rival dislike. Oh, he hates us, if you guys remember. He hates us because we challenged him to a duel. Now, I'm not sure really why we dueled him. Well, I wanted to duel him because it was fun. It was fun embarrassing the king. I think we didn't have the greatest relations before the duel, and spanking him in that duel really didn't make things better. He now absolutely hates us and now is taking up revenge in the middle of a civil war that he's barely winning, and he's kidnapped Rickon Stark. We can't let him kidnap Starks. As Tywin once said, if another house can seize one of our own and hold them captive with impunity, then we are no longer a house to be feared. And we need to remind King Renly that winter is coming, and you do not fuck with the Starks. So, the insolence, we will demand their release at once. An envoy is sent demanding your kin's release, threatening revenge if ignored. I don't know if we can join Tywin in his war. Could we? We could. We could if he really wants to fuck around. I mean, Tywin likes us a lot more than Renly does. If Renly does not release Rickon Stark, we will join the Lion. We will join the Lion. Renly, your ally in the Reach is gone, and Tywin, you only have a slight advantage over Tywin. Well, we'll see what the stag does. The envoy has returned. Oh, shit. The envoy has returned from King's Landing, only without their head. King Renly Baratheon had my kinsmen executed, flagrantly ignoring my demand for my other kin's release, and in doing so, has earned the ire of all of House Stark. Winter is coming. It's House Stark and Baratheon will enter a blood feud. Oh, shit. And I think the music is just... The music has just on cue. Ladies and gentlemen. King Renly has... He has truly overstepped. He is now proven. He's essentially taken up the position as Mad King. Now, he's not an actual lunatic, but he is definitely a fucking tyrant. And he's very much hated. And now has made a mortal enemy of House Stark. I think it is time, ladies and gentlemen. We didn't want to fight. We didn't want this fight. Not yet, at least. But it is time. Call the banners. All of them. Winter is coming. And it is coming for King Renly. Let's see. Bloody Vengeance. Lord Paramount Eddard of the North is in a deadly feud with King Renly of the Empty Pockets. And can you just cast a spell to take their vengeance? Let's see. King Renly is imprisoned by Lord Paramount Eddard. All Baratheons in King's Landing shall be taken prisoner. King Renly pays us 500 gold, and we get 100 prestige from war contribution. Yes, but here's the thing. I don't really want that. Instead, I think I want to fight for, let's see, attacking in tyranny. Okay, in favor of... We're going to side with the Lion. We're going to decide upon Civil War sides. You're presented with the option to either support your liege, King Renly, or if allowed, join Tywin Lannister in their Civil War. We will join the Lannisters. The Iron Throne is an ongoing... Is in an ongoing state of war. Renly Baratheon is in conflict with Tywin Lannister and expects us to provide men for his armies. What shall we do? Yes, to defend my liege is my duty. I will not concern myself for now. The rebels' cause is just... Renly, you done fucked up now. The rebels' cause is just... We will join Lord Tywin. And I was kind of expecting to be able to see my allies' stuff, but let's go ahead and raise... Call the banners. All of them. Let's see, we've got House Yon. Who are they? They are House Royce. No, they're not Royce, are they? Let's see. Let's go to Runestone. Yes, that is House Royce. That's not good. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to pull back the men to the twins. That's what I want to do. And I want to secure the neck ASAP while we gather all our armies. We march south. The King's Landing for Rickon. Alright, they should all be able to survive there at Greywater Watch. Everyone's marching down there, right? Greywater Watch. Okay. Everyone. I would raise our ships, but I don't think we have any ships. Alright. So we're gonna go total all-out war now. Is King's Landing open to us? 5,000 men. Renly is in the field in Payne Hall. Ah, there he is. Now we need to get all of our counselors in a position to where we can use them. So let's start sowing dissent in King's Landing. Castellan Lord Benjen oversee the realm, improve defenses, pacify the province, levy reinforcement rate. Ooh. Levy size goes up, local revolt risk goes down, improved defenses, tasks was overseeing the administration of the realm. I thought this gave like a passive tax boost, but it seems just to give you, let's see, demean improved, smugglers enter demean, special tithe collected. Ooh, that special tithe can be really, really nice. Improved defenses, garrison goes up. Yeah, I don't really think Winterfell is in danger of being attacked. But we do want to sow dissent here in King's Landing. We want to keep training our men. We want to keep collecting taxes. We're building a spy network here. I suppose we could sabotage the economy in King's Landing, but that's kind of... It's really not that good. It's just because a lot of times a lord's income is not based off of a single territory. Or a single county. It's often based off of all of them. So sabotaging economy doesn't really work. But right now, the Riverlands is very vulnerable, so we need to get back to King's Landing. I think I've pulled back all Riverlander forces to the Twins. Catelyn's off here fighting her own little war, which is... Alright. Can we plot to rescue him? No. Ask to ransom prisoner. Gold is good, but he really, really hates us. He might even execute Rickon, for all we know. He might. That's why King Renly must fall. Offer non-aggression pact. Wireless, I promise you, if you take up arms for the king, you will regret it. You will regret it. But we are marching. The Paps. Who are the fucking Paps? I don't know who the Paps are. They have 900 men. They're pulling back. Get them to the twins as well. We've got... Okay! My lord, his grace, King Renly, has taken his last breath. May he repose in peace. Now his heir, Prince Aemon Baratheon, will take the throne and will rule the Seven Kingdoms. Okay, so he died in personal combat. He apparently was mangled. Who killed him? Was shockingly slain by the rogue Kingsguard, Rickard Fell. You bloody legend! You bloody legend! Sir Rickard, the Oathbreaker. He's essentially he is Jaime Lannister. He is Jaime Lannister. Swollen ankle, known murderer, wounded. He killed King Renly. That is amazing. Was shockingly slain by the rogue Kingsguard. Rickard Fell, you did right by the realm. You did right by the realm, in my honest opinion. Now, he did. Now, of course, Eddard Stark would absolutely condemn such an action. He would condemn it wholeheartedly, but deep down, I think Eddard is a little relieved knowing that the king who imprisoned his son is now dead. And Rickon is back. Rickon is back. However, he did lose his marriage to, who was that? Who was that person? Was it Eleni? Eleni? She's quick. There's also Kaleria. Cool name. Lord Bayard. Bayard. Is there anyone we can betroth you to? No Starks, but we certainly could rearrange that marriage, that betrothal, with Rickon. He will not agree. Political concerns. How about we give you some money? And when I mean some, I mean 100 gold. Are we still allies? No, we must rebuild this alliance with the Reach. Send them 100 gold. We certainly can afford it. And now he loves us. Good. And he still will not give us a fucking non-aggression pact. Maybe we have to wait for the war to be over. Will you at least arrange this betrothal? Olenna Tyrell. So, let's see. She'll come of age in about 10 years. Rickon will be 26. That's fine. Okay, so he's considering. So, long live the king. King Renly, empty pockets. His reign of mismanagement and tyranny has come to an end at the hands of a rogue Kingsguard. Excellent. Our enemy has died. The war is over. And it seems he likes us now. Sent gift, joined my war, joined the cause. Yes. Out of curiosity. Tywin. We actually don't have any more Starks. At least not. We have to wait for Rob to revert back to our throne, and then we can start marrying off his children. But everyone else seems to be rather taken. Sansa, Lady Victoria. I mean, they are Greyjoys. We don't have enough Starks. Our enemy has died. Well, Tywin, it was a good war while it lasted. All right, let's just disband the men. And luckily enough, we actually didn't have to lose any soldiers. Okay, let's disband you one at a time. Apparently, that's how we're going to do this. Well, who rules now? To the heroic Lord Paramount Eddard, may you live in harmony and contentment. I have decided to accept your suggestion of a betrothal. Excellent. Will you form an alliance? You will not. Let's wait for this to be over. Let's see. We've got King Aemon of the Iron Throne. He is age 2, so he probably won't last long. And then, are you fucking kidding me? After that, it's Joffrey Lannister. Fucking Joffrey, he's come back. He's come back from the dead. See, loan taken. He doesn't have a lot of money. His dad was... Why does he hate us? Blood feud. Ah. Well, yep. King Aemon, your father, started a blood feud with House Stark. We're not going to swear fealty. Cannot if we actually could go to war with him again. We could go to war with him again, and we could actually end the blood feud. Tywin... It says he only has 5,000 men. Well, you know what? If we're gonna get independence. All right. Fucking goddamn it! The wars between the great powers of the realm have subsided, and the Iron Throne has come back. What is the Veil doing? The Veil. Guys, let me know in the comment section. How do I get a claim on the Veil? What kind of scenario do I need to set up if I want to get if one day I want to have a child or heir who has claims on the North, the Riverlands, and the Vale? Because if we can take all of that, we can create an amazing kingdom. Just right now, I can't imagine how we're gonna get the Vale. One disadvantage of having army movement locked is that you kind of have to wait to disband your men. It's kind of annoying. See, because we can't disband them if they're currently locked and they're marching. All right, go ahead and disband you two. Ugh. Maybe there should be an option where if you're marching armies in peacetime and their movement is locked, you still can disband them. That'd be nice. All right, then we'll just disband all of you. Great. Fucking goddamn it. It's gonna take forever. You know what we could do? No, we can't. We can't even stop their movement. We have to wait till their movement is no longer locked. Shit! Okay. Disband. Eddard, your armies are too large. But now may be the time. Crown Loyalists, Lord Paramount Tywin for the Iron Throne. Lots of Crown Loyalists. I don't like that. Let's see, Lord Gawain of Harvest Hall. No Lord Paramounts, though. Let's see, seniority, succession, Queen Daenerys for the Iron Throne, no. Lord Stannis for the Iron Throne, no. Shireen, no. Marcella, no. Depose King Aemon in favor of... Wait a minute, what is this? In favor of his heir, no. Overthrow the monarchy. Oh, apologies. No, the people have spoken. It is time for independence. Holy crap. Holy shit. 171. We can send him a demand right now and pretty much say, can we send the ultimatum? Demand independence. I would like to have an ally on my side eventually. Okay, you guys, disband all the armies. Let's disband the armies first. Give the king an actual chance to, Lord Paramount Theon the Treacherous usurped some stupid title. Okay, someone was born to somebody Trent, don't care. Disband the last of the armies. I also feel like we should, conclude our blood feud, but perhaps we will. Alright. King Aemon has no allies. He has 22,000 men. Let's see, how many allies do we have? We have Theon Greyjoy. Somehow we have become allied. He only has 5,000 men. What a damn loser. Damn loser. Shit. I really wish we had more stocks. Olenna Tyrell. Okay. Mace. Form an alliance, you bastard. Damn you. I need your men. He's probably thinking to himself, he's like, those damn Starks always pulling us into wars. Maybe they're tired of it. No political concerns. Yeah, I'm not sure what that's about. I mean, we could send an ultimatum right now. We could. The war for independence. Bloody vengeance. Whoa, what is this? Lordship of Old Castle. Lord Paramount Eddard can choose to either usurp or vassalize the Eddard Stark. Oh, if we win the war. High Lordship of the Dreadfort becomes Lord Ramsay's new liege. I don't know what the fuck that's about. Can attempt to declare independence. What's more important, independence or the bloody feud? I think independence is going to be more important. And for some reason, our allies, the Greyjoys, will not fucking aid us. I mean, we're supposedly allies, but I don't know. Let's see what Lord Wyless's opinion of his liege is. King Aemon's opinion of Lord Wyless, Lord Paramount Wyless's opinion of King Aemon is 5. So he likes us a lot more. I think it is time. I think it is time, ladies and gentlemen. It is time for the North to rise up in revolution. Alright, the Iron King, the Iron Throne, and the Copper King will rule us no longer. We demand independence. Do it. We can call in our allies, and we will send a raven to Lord Paramount Theon the Treacherous. Not the best ally. Form an alliance. No, he still will not do it. Tywin! Will you aid us? No, you won't. All right, well, we are at war with King Aemon. He has 7,000 men. Apparently just 7,000. Who rules, Oh, Lord Edric Storm rules in Storm's End. Wow. He has 7,000 men. Now, here's the thing. He's going to have more than that. He's going to have more. Go ahead and... let's see. Total troops with our armies here. 7,000. Maybe we should march them to River Run. 38K. 55K. No, march them to Harrenhal. Forward position. Harrenhal. And then everyone else. All northern armies, march to River Run. All northern armies, go to River Run. Or perhaps we should meet up at the Neck first before we march south. Or the Twins. You know what? I think the Twins would be better. The Twins might be better. Let's march to the Twins. Although I absolutely detest the Freys. I detest all the Freys. We will send them down to the Twins. And they will gather there, and we'll have a secondary army gather at the Riverlands. And we will look, before I end the episode, we will get all of this in order, because we've been kind of letting our minor titles kind of fall to the wayside. And we have lots of commanders. Walder the Black. Yeah, you know what? How about we have people who are actually good? Lord Tytos the Gallant. Roos. Master Helmet of Torren Square shall be replaced with Carl, Master Roderick the Rash. Roderick, you are 57, sir. Surely we can get someone. Oh, we've got Rob. We can always use Rob. I did see we had Ramsay Bolton there, too. Lord Carl the Priest Hater. Nice. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, that will have to conclude this episode. The North has entered a blood feud with House Baratheon thanks to the former tyrannical King Renly, the empty pockets of the Copper Throne Chair. And now we march for independence against his son, the 2-year-old boy King Aemon, with a mere 7,000 men. Now, we don't know how this war will develop. All the Lord Paramounts might join King Aemon. I'm not sure why they would. But they certainly could, and that would make our war that much more difficult. The Reach is no longer our staunch ally. They refuse because of political concerns. I think they intend to go to war with us in the future. But that, ladies and gentlemen, will have to take place in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. As always, this has been Crusader Kings 2, The Wolf's Revenge. Ooh! Okay, enough for me. I have been the Golden Joeblivion, and until next time, I will see you all later.